Hi, welcome to NITTT and Online SWAYAM Module 7, Creative Problem Solving, Innovation and Meaningful R&D, Graded Assessment 5. Question 1. Experimental research aims at determining option A, tentative cause and effect relationships, option B, true cause and effect relationships, option C, relationship between two variables, option D, status of process, opinions, reactions, etc. And correct option is option B, true cause and effect relationships. Question 2. Which of the following is a necessary condition for a true experimental study? Option A, random selection of the sample. Option B, random assignment of groups to experimental and control group. Option C, both option A and B. Option D, neither option A nor option B. And the correct option is option C, both option A and B. Question 3. In experimental designs, the following symbol O1, X, O2, O3, O4 represents option A, post-test design only, option B, pre-test post-test design, option C, pre-test post-test control group design, option D, pre-test post-test one group design. And correct option is option C, pre-test post-test control group design. Question 4. As a teacher, if you are taking 3 intact classes and teach them by 3 different instructional strategies to see their effect on achievement of students, the design of research will be option A, ex post facto research, option B, true experimental design, option C, pseudo experimental research, option D, quasi experimental research. And correct option is option D, quasi experimental research. Question 5. External validity refers to option A, that the effect is attributable to the intervention, option B, that there is no effect of external variables, option C, the generalizability of study to other settings, option D, cause and effect relationship established by the study cannot be explained by other factors. And correct option is option C, the generalizability of study to other settings. Question 6. The characteristic of action research include option A, context specific, option B, undertaken by the practitioner, option C, findings are implemented by the practitioner, option D, all of the above. And correct option is option D, all of the above. Question 7. In action research, option A, rigorous controls are exercised, option B, random selection of sample is done, option C, random assignment to groups is done, option D, none of the above. And correct option is option D, none of the above. Question 8. The findings of action research undertaken by the trainer to improve effectiveness of his training are applicable to option A, his institution, option B, all trainees in his institution, option C, trainees in his program, option D, all other training institutions. And correct option is option C, trainees in his program. Question 9. Which of the following can be a hypothesis of an experimental study? Option A, there is no difference in the technical skills possessed by girls and boys. Option B, there is a significant effect of structured industrial training on the problem solving ability of the final year student of IT. Option C, there is a significant relationship between age and height of senior secondary school students. Option D, there exist significant differences in the attitude towards technology of students from general and technical education. And the correct option is option B, there is a significant effect of structured industrial training on the problem solving ability of the final year student of IT. Question 10. Which of the following factors can affect the external validity of an experimental study? Option A, history. Option B, maturation. Option C, pretesting. Option D, selection treatment interaction. And correct option is option D, selection treatment interaction. Thanks for watching.